Hey, buddies, welcome to Video Games Awesome Live. This is a show and trailer for, what month is it? May. Yeah. At the end of May, we're wrapping up.
Hey, it's May 2 for today.
Is it really?
Good fucking job!
Victoria Day, Commonwealth, everybody. Long live the Queen.
Fuck that bitch.
She's pretty cool.
I'm with Ben. She's first done nothing frozen, for me.
Now
what's she
queen.
Done for me lately? Nothing.
Oh, man. Anyways, let's start to kick this off with a brand new Call of Duty.
Oh, I really hope she watches it and does this bit
take. Is it the one with the dog?
Keeper Sutherland.
What? Is right. Space. And I have the power.
Frank fucking Underwood.
Nice.
Oh.
Is this what he was playing on his show too? Call of Duty?
It's straight up, basically, listen to the voice here. It's just Frank Underwood. Nice. It's like not even, you know.
Determines who's right. And I have the power.
Yeah.
So I'm
got the
right.
Same draw.
Yeah, it's the exact same. Let me swap my
Does anyone
audio.
Know what game he was playing on the show? On House of Cards?
Oh, yeah, a shooter.
Like nothing specific. It wasn't Call of Duty or.
Oh, they made it up. They made a game.
Did they really?
Yeah, yeah. Not yet rated. It would have been cool, but yeah.
Yeah.
I fucking love House of Cards.
Yup.
Oh god.
All right, here we go. Here's the actual trailer.
Democracy.
It was the OG, but that guy.
Democracy is not what these people need. Hell, it's not even what they want. America's been trying to install democracies in nations for a century. And it hasn't worked
Whoa,
one
what the
time.
Fuck?
Yeah, man.
That's awesome.
He's pared back the drawl a tiny bit, but it's Frank Underwood.
These countries don't have the most basic building blocks to support a democracy.
Whoa. That was a big jump.
Little things like we ought to be tolerant of those who disagree with us. We ought to be tolerant of those who worship a different god than us.
Gonna fix the Ashley games?
Did he what?
A journalist ought to be able to disagree with the president.
I don't know. I wonder.
He might.
Anybody in there spy on him?
March into these countries based on some fundamentalist religious principles, drop a few bombs, topple a dictator, and start a democracy?
I don't know if we can call it modern warfare anymore. It's all future warfare now.
Yeah.
Give me a
modern
break.
Future.
People don't want freedom. They want boundaries, rules.
Protection. Yeah, that's robots.
From invaders and from themselves.
I wonder how big of a part he has in
both the support and the constraints to keep chaos at bay.
We could be seeing his whole. He gets shot in the head right after this.
You give them that. They'll follow.
Spacey out.
That's where I come in.
I fucking love that man.
Yeah.
You would sleep with him.
Yeah.
I'd let you sleep with him.
Thank you.
Let him go down on you like with in House of Cards. I don't care how charming or handsome he is, it was still a creepy scene.
Yeah, it really
is.
Kind of
was.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm just remembering something, and I won't say anything about from season 2. Have you guys watched season 2?
Yeah, we've seen it, but they might not.
Yeah,
we can't say anything. So I do wonder how much he's in it, because I can tell you after watching Godzilla, disappointed.
No Cranston? Yeah.
Cranston's
not in it that much.
In a few scenes. Basically, what you saw on the trailer, that's Cranston.
That's a disappointment.
That's it. I was expecting he was the protagonist. Guess who the protagonist is?
Oh, is it a young kid?
Kick-Ass.
Yeah.
The guy who played Kick-Ass. Yeah. I didn't even, the trailers didn't even show a glimpse of him, I thought.
Yeah, just little pieces.
A very and small glimpse.
If you weren't looking carefully, you might not recognize him as...
Did he have a British accent?
We totally didn't.
Well, the weirdest part was his voice.
Oh, really?
He's jacked. He's fucking ripped.
He still has
that tiny little wimpy voice in it. It's, I should have actually put together a Godzilla segment so we could talk about it at length, but I want to go. I don't want to go on a diatribe.
Muscle mass alone in that movie.
Squad member act.
Oh. What? So who gives a shit about space?
What up, though? My name is Big Snoop D-O-double-G, and I'm here
Ghost
live and direct.
Snoop.
He's back to
Call
Snoop.
Of Duty.
Yeah.
Or Ghost back to Dog.
Snoop Dogg.
Yeah, it didn't really.
You did.
I thought he was
high.
I thought he was Snoop Diddy.
Those are some fine ass threads. You got that Spitfire drone now.
We're here today.
How old?
Mid 50s, I'm saying.
And he's doing the MP announcer package.
rack up points by reaching the enemy portal, you dig?
What interests me the most about the project 30s. Is that my voice could be connected with a game.
And when we were like 10, I remember
it
being
associated with
a thing.
A squad member active, a brother from another. And he was a young guy when he was, I didn't think he was a young guy when I was little.
I think the writers did a good job on creating lines for me specifically.
How old is Snoop Dogg, guys?
He's only 43!
Really?
Wow!
Oh, I was gonna say he was at least in his 50s.
Time has not been kind to that drug-addled face.
He was a rapper playing this game. I know a lot of us are big fans.
Embracing that Rasta lifestyle.
Like I say, it's the coolest game in the hood. All my homies play this game.
He's pretty much looked the same since he was
Yeah, that's true.
18, though.
Strung out for life. All right,
so he's in Call of Duty 2?
No, he's in Ghosts. I just thought it was interesting.
Oh.